Sometimes there's code that you want to share that doesn't require the full scope of a project. It doesn't need all the subdirectories. It's just a few files that may be for a specific feature or some one-off functionality. A way that you can do that in GitHub is through what's called a gist. To create a gist, you can go up to this plus sign, and here instead of a new repository, we'll do new gist. And here you can see a basic idea of what this looks like. At the top, you can give a description, my first gist, you know, whatever you want, something to describe what this is. And here you can give the name of this specific file. So this in itself will be a file, and the extension. So depending on whatever it is, if it's a SQL file, Python, HTML, whatever. Let's just do test gist.py, just a basic Python file. You can change the indent mode, the size, if you want it to wrap. We'll just say print hello world. You can make this as complicated or as simple as you want. You can easily add more files here by just clicking that add file button. And you know, maybe you had file2.py, and that's really it. So you're just adding files, however much or little that you want. And now down here, you can say create a public gist or a secret one. Pretty self-explanatory, depending on how you want to use this, whether you want it to be restricted or for anyone to see. I'll create a public one for now and select create public gist. And here we can see it. Over here on the right, there's a couple options for what would you like to do. You can embed this, share, or clone. In this case, I'll clone it. And now that I'm back in Visual Studio, I'll open up a terminal and do the standard git clone, but with the URL of that gist. And when we run that, we see this right here. This is that gist that we just made with the two files. So as you can see, it's very easy to just throw up some files and share them with whoever you want for them to see and begin to interact with it. Now, let's say you wanted to edit it. What you can do is very simply go to edit and do whatever you want. Let's say more lines. Maybe we want to add another file and update. Here it is. And over here on revisions, we can see the history of what happened. Now, remember, we cloned this just like we cloned a regular repository, and really, at the core, these are also repositories. So that means if we go back in here, I'm going to change into this directory. If we look at the branch, we have a master branch, and we can pull and get these changes. So now we've gotten these changes as well that we just edited over here. So that'll do it for this video about gist. Hopefully now you have an understanding of how these work, how you can make your own. And then from there, it's up to really your imagination in terms of how you want to use these and implement them in your projects.